Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar, and today we are going to talk about what intermittent fasting is. So you might have come across this word intermittent fasting by now because it has been quite trending on internet. First of all, don't be afraid of this word. This simply means, intermittent means in between, fasting means not eating anything. So sometimes people think that fasting is only eating fruits and vegetables and not eating grains. But here we are talking about not eating, only we can drink water, we will not eat any sort of food, no fruits, vegetables, nothing. So intermittent fasting is eating in a particular time frame and not eating in a particular time frame. So basically fasting in a particular time frame and eating in a particular time frame. So now you would say that, oh, I do that every day. I'll eat from 1:30 to 2 p.m. and then I'll not eat from 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. and then I'll again eat from 5 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. So I am doing intermittent fasting. See, it is not like that. See, your body takes a lot of time to digest your food. First, it goes into your stomach, then it goes to your small intestine, then it goes to your large intestine, and then it comes and the waste comes out. So your body can take more than 10 hours to completely digest your food. We will consider the time after which your body starts feeling hungry again. When you are basically your body is ready to get more food and digest it. So which is usually around 2 to 4 or 5 hours or 6 hours frame. So once you have a meal after 3, 4, 5 or 6 hours, you are hungry again when your body is ready to get another meal. So we'll consider that time frame after which your body is kind of somewhat free from the food that you ate. And in the initial 2 hours frame, when you eat, when you have your meal, initially by digesting your meal your blood sugar goes up, and after around 2 hours your body takes the blood sugar down for a normal healthy human being. Okay, so the examples would be for intermittent fasting would be that you would start eating after sunrise and you will stop eating before sunset. And again you repeat the procedure. So basically you will be eating only in the daytime, after sunrise, before sunset, and after sunset to next day's sunrise you will not eat anything. So approximately you'll not be eating any food for 12 hours and you'll be eating food in the rest of the 12 hours frame. Another can be out of the 24 hours you're eating your food in 8 hours frame and not eating your food in the rest of the 16 hours frame. So you'll eat you'll start eating around 10 a.m. in the morning and you'll stop eating around 6 p.m. in the evening. That is just a frame that we chose for example. And then from 6 p.m. in the evening to the next day's 10 a.m. in the morning, you will not eat anything. So, so in the evening at 6 p.m. you had your last meal. Now after 4 or 5 hours or so, your body has done quite a lot of work to digest it and it can be ready for the next meal. It is quite free from the digestion work of the previous meal, although it takes more time to completely digest it, but it is ready for the next meal. So once it's your body gets free from the previous meal, it gets time to do a lot of things. First of all, it gets rest. If you keep feeding your body every 3 hours, 1 p.m., 4 p.m., 7 p.m., 10 p.m., then once the body gets free from the previous meal, you give it the next meal to digest and you keep doing it. So your body does not get rest. When you give it a bigger time frame, so like in the case of let's say 16:8 in 24 hours, you eat in 8 hours frame and not eat in 16 hours frame. So when you give your body a bigger time frame to rest, it gets rest, it does, so according to our holy spiritual text, it does purification of itself, it does get time to purify itself, it will collect the waste materials from itself and it will try to get rid of the waste materials, and so basically it purifies itself. And then when your body is not getting food, then it might derive energy from your fat, which can help it in burning fat. Otherwise, your body stays in busy in digesting food if you keep eating all the time. And another method of intermittent fasting can be that you eat, you do not eat food in for one day in a week. So basically, you eat food in 6 days and you don't eat food on one day. Or maybe you do not eat food for 2 days in a week and eat for 5 days a week. Or you do not eat alternate days. So there are a lot of types of intermittent fasting, and there are really a lot of advantages of intermittent fasting. I am going to be talking about them in detail in my future videos. Now, make sure that even in intermittent fasting and otherwise, you eat only when you are hungry, and you try to eat a bit lesser than your hunger. This should be for your entire life. This should be a principle for your entire life. When you eat a bit lesser than your hunger, then you are kind of using your digestive system, which is a machine, lesser than what it can be used for. You are using it lesser than its capacity. So basically, you are using the machine lesser than its capacity. So you are kind of extending the lifespan of the machine. So basically, you are kind of extending your lifespan. So you are probably going to live longer. Now, this term intermittent fasting and has been in trend in science for past few years, but our ancestors have been practicing the methods of intermittent fasting for hundreds or thousands of years in multiple religions and almost all regions of India. Science is still researching on it, but the holy spiritual texts known as Shastra, they have already talked about a lot of benefits of intermittent fasting. I am going to be discussing them in detail in my future videos. Some of the advantages in brief is that it extends our lifespan, helps in weight loss, it helps us get rid of diseases like cancer and diabetes and many more diseases. So when you do not eat, for example, if you do not eat 2 days in a week, so you are kind of not supplying energy to your body, energy to your body. So the bad cells in your body, which grow and foster based on the energy that you supply to your body, they do not get adequate amount of energy, so they die, and hence you get slowly you get rid of your disease. And longer life and weight loss. See, intermittent fasting you eat in a short period of time, so it is hard to eat too much in a short period of time, as you have lesser time to eat, and you will eat only when you are hungry. So it is more likely that you are naturally going to eat lesser. So when you eat lesser, I told you, you eat lesser, your machine, your digestive system, your body is a machine, you use it less, so the machine works for a longer period of time. So basically, you kind of extend your lifespan. And when you naturally tend to eat lesser, you tend to lose weight because you are eating lesser than you are burning, than the amount of energy that you are burning. But if you are trying, so let's say if you are eating, if you are fasting 1 day in a week, so on the rest of the 6 days, if you are trying to compensate for that 1 day eating a lot of food more than your hunger, then perhaps you are not going to get the benefits of intermittent fasting, or you can even harm your health. I'll talk about a lot of things about intermittent fasting in my future videos, so please keep an eye on them. It is a really important topic. If you like this video, please like, comment and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.